Hey everyone, welcome to my channel. Today I wanted to talk a bit about the different colors that I have on my palette, and you can choose to curate your palette to better suit your style of painting. I love painting bright flowers, and when I was making this painting, I realized I used almost all the colors on my palette. These are my go-to colors, and I feel my palette is complete for my style of painting, and I wanted to share a bit about my favorite colors with everyone. Starting with, the first color that I feel every palette should have is red. But this is not really red, this is a bit of a mix of vermilion hue, and it's a bright orangish red shade. If you want to make it darker, you can always achieve that by mixing. This is a beautiful color to have for painting bright red flowers like poppies. The red color that usually comes in the pre-made palette is very deep and they are not as bright, and it is very difficult to mix watercolors to get those brighter vibrant values. So for brighter shades like this, I prefer not mixing them. The vermilion hue, as you can see, is very bright. It is orange with a reddish tinge and it is perfect for those red colored flowers. Let me show you how it looks now when you reduce the value. So this is a beautiful color to have on your palette if you're into floral paintings. Okay, the next color on my palette is the red violet, and this color is the main reason why I decided to curate my own palette, because I use it so much. I use this color so much that the pre-made palettes were falling short of it, and most of the pre-made palettes do not have this color. You can make this color by mixing red and blue and add more red to get the reddish violet color. But as I said before, I feel the vibrancy is lost when you mix watercolors, so I prefer having this color on my palette. Another similar but deeper shade is the Bordeaux. I didn't swatch it here, but that is another great shade to have on your palette. So let's swatch it and see how it looks. It's a beautiful vibrant color, and I bet you'll use it a lot if you're into florals. Now let's see a lighter value of this shade. Another shade is the violet, which is again a mix of red and blue, and more blue this time than red. Good to have this straight out of the tube instead of mixing, as it will be one of the most used colors on your palette. My next favorite color on my palette is the brown red. I use this a lot for branches on trees, and it can also be mixed with vermilion hue to get the darker red shade, which can be used for darker petals when you're making red flowers. Another primary color to have on your palette is the yellow. You can either choose between a permanent yellow deep or a permanent yellow light. There's only a slight difference between these two colors. I will swatch the permanent yellow deep here. It has a beautiful shade for yellow flowers. The third primary color that every palette must have is the blue. I feel the cobalt blue is the most used, and probably you already have it in one of your pre-made palettes. You don't need to buy it. Along with the cobalt blue, I also like having cerulean blue on my palette. I place the two blues in the same section on my palette, and I feel they look great when they are mixed together. I will swatch both the blues. Let's see how the cobalt blue looks like first. Then next, I will swatch cerulean blue. It's a beautiful lighter shade of blue and very vibrant. I use this usually to make the sky backgrounds in my paintings. Now for the leaves, my favorite is the olive green. Most artists would recommend sap green, which is more vibrant, but I like the olive green better because I feel it has more realistic shade for leaves. And you can always achieve the lighter shade by mixing it with more yellow. My next favorite color, and probably the most used color, is the perlene green. I even went ahead and splurged on this shade because I use it so much. This is from Schmincke. It is a great one for those darker leaves and shadows, and you can even use it as a mixer for darker shades. So these are my most used shades. Apart from these, I also like to have some lighter tones, which help give more vibrancy to the colors. One of those colors is the Opera. It is a really bright light pink. You can even dilute the shade to make a pale pink color for flowers, which looks so delicate. Let's see how it looks first. As you can see, it's really bright, almost neon-like. You may not use it as it is, but it is a good mixer to have when you want to give more vibrancy to the reds and pinks. Similarly, one more almost neon-like color is the lemon yellow, which is again a good mixer to give that vibrant tones to your yellows and greens. Let's swatch it. You can see the difference between the two yellows and how they can be used together. Lastly, another yellow to have is the yellow ochre, which is difficult to get through mixing, so I would suggest you have it on your palette. I don't use it that often, but I find it handy when I want to show darker petals when I'm painting yellow flowers. Next color in the lighter, brighter tones is the sap green. Let's swatch it. It is not a really realistic color to have for botanical art, but it makes for a good mixer and a good color to show the lighter leaves which are perhaps in the sun. So this is it. These are my top 13 favorite colors to have on my palette for floral watercolor paintings. I hope you like this video and it is helpful for you to curate your own palette. Don't forget to subscribe to my YouTube channel and follow me on Instagram for more watercolor paintings. Thank you.